Hi friends, today we are going to see that how we can use DSP in array antennas and how we can actually rotate or spare or steer the beam of an antenna. Now let us first understand what do you mean by array antenna. So we are going to see what do you mean by array antenna. Now we know that antenna is a transmitting or a receiving device which receives and transmits electromagnetic waves. Now, if suppose I have two radiators placed side by side, okay, they are operated at same frequency, let's say same amplitude, and there is some distance d between them. Okay, what is going to happen? Let's say this antenna radiates like this, okay, whereas this antenna radiates like this. So what will be the addition? Okay, if suppose they are destructively adding over this region, there is an overlay of two regions, and if suppose there is a destructive addition in this overlaid region, which I show like this, in this region the overlay is destructive. What is going to happen? Both of them are radiating with same let's say amplitude, and both of them are adding or subtracting each other, so there will be no transmission in this side, whereas there will be transmission on this side and transmission on this side, but there will be no transmission on this side, so or reception of signal from this side, because antenna cannot look in that direction. Okay, so this radiation pattern is called as the beam of an antenna. So every antenna will have a beam of an antenna. So how we characterize an antenna? We characterize an antenna by its beam. So let's say this is my antenna. I say that this is the majority axis, which contributes major radiation. So let's say my antenna is radiating maximum in this direction. Okay. But along with that direction, there is some radiation like this also. Okay. So this is called as the main lobe of an antenna or the antenna beam, and this is the antenna look direction, the maximum looking distance or maximum looking energy in this direction. So antenna can receive maximum signals from here and can transmit maximum signals in this direction. These are called as side lobes. Now if side lobes are of significant length or strength, then the antenna can also receive signals from this side lobes. What is the major point in receiving the antenna, in receiving the signal? If suppose I wanted to receive only from one direction, that means from this direction, then if any signal is coming from this, other sides are all what? Interference for me, isn't it? So what I want, that I want to reduce the side lobes and I want the maximum antenna to look in one particular direction, isn't it? Now if you design one antenna, it will look only in one direction, that is its characteristics. Okay, you can have an antenna which is looking in all 360 direction, but then there is no antenna selectivity. Okay, you can design an antenna which can look very, which can have a beam which is of pencil beam size or very narrow beam size. Okay, but once you design that antenna, it will always radiate in that direction, or it will always radiate in that fashion only. Suppose I don't wanted I wanted to look into 360 degree, but I don't want it to look into 360 degree always. For example, of radar. In radar, the antenna needs to look into all the directions, but not simultaneously in all the direction, because if you start receiving echoes from all the direction, it will be really difficult for you to analyze that which is the actual echo, or and to which echo I need to look into, or from which direction the echo is coming, isn't it? So to give that directionality, what we use is, we use a narrow pencil beam, a beam which is having a narrow size, and we rotate the antenna. That's why the radar antenna are rotating. because I want that antenna beam to look in all 360 direction, but not at the all times. I want it to look in particular direction at particular instant of time. So I can say that at this instant of time, the target is at this location. Okay. So for that reason, I have to rotate the whole stuff or the whole antenna, isn't it? But we can take the advantage of arrays of antenna and steer the beam very well. Or we can use the arrays of antennas, and by feeding the antenna in particular fashion, we can actually neglect some area from being transmitted, and we can give some benefit to the other area. So that means we can change the gain of an antenna in particular direction. Likewise, over here we have seen, if we are feeding in this type, then this area is not getting any benefits. That means the gain over here is poor, whereas over here and over here we have sent a decent amount of gain. Okay, so this is what the array antenna means. What do you mean by array of antenna? Array antenna is nothing but the elements or the radiators placed in the spectral configuration. There will be some set of configuration. This is called as a linear array because it is placed in one direction only. You can have two directions linear array, in which we will have matrix of array. For example, we can have an array antenna placed like this in the columns and in the rows direction. So it will be, I will be placing the radiators, let's say, so I have placed total 9 radiators, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 radiators, and let's say they all are placed equidistant from each other. So this is a matrix of array, isn't it? And what is going to happen? I'm going to receive the input from each of the radiator. So there will be multiples of inputs, isn't it? So this is how an array antenna works. So using the array antenna, feeding them in proper, placing them in proper configuration, spectrally, that means in space, and feeding them in particular order with particular phases, we can actually move the beam of the antenna, or we can actually have a total nullification of the beam in particular direction. Okay, so that is achieved using array of antenna. Now, how DSP can be used in this method? So adaptive filtering or adaptive algorithm has actually very well proven that we can use that algorithm, which adaptive algorithm, in antenna theory, and we can actually steer the beam correctly. Now let us consider a 5-element antenna system which are placed at certain d distance away from each other, and we say that from each of the antenna I am going to get one sequence. First antenna produces x1 of n. Likewise, fifth antenna produce x5 of n. So how many total sequences? 5 total sequences are being received from an antenna or transmitted from an antenna. With this configuration, this is the radiation pattern that I am observing. This is my look direction, because maximum radiation is in this direction. This is my main lobe and these are my side lobes. Now suppose I am receiving an interference from this side. So I am receiving the major signal from this side, plus I am receiving an interference which will be picked up, which might be picked up by 3, 4, 5. I'm going to get some random sequences. Why? Because of the interference, isn't it? So what I wanted to do? I wanted to reduce this part as much as I can, but adaptively, because it is never known that the interference might come only from this direction. The interference might come from this direction also. That time I wanted to reduce this side. That's why we use adaptive algorithm, because according to the interference, we need to adaptively change our antenna pattern. So how to modify this? So what will be the total sequence at the receiver side or at the transmitter side? The total sequence, okay, the total sequence can be written as, the total sequence, I can write it as x of n, which is a total, which is nothing but summation of, okay, let's say k going from 1 to 5 xk of n, okay, which results in this pattern. Okay, so I have x of n, which is addition of all the 5 samples, and which produces this radiation pattern. Suppose I wanted to neglect the interference completely,
what I will do, I will energize such a way this array that I will not receive any of the input from or any of the radiation in this side, isn't it? So by properly weighing this x1 to x5, I can achieve a amplitude variation of the or power variation of the side lobes. Okay, so what I'll do, I had this to get the achieve the normal radiation pattern. Now what I'll do, I will weigh. So we are doing weighing of input. So when I weigh the input, I'm going to get x of n to be equal to summation k goes from 1 to 5 hk of n x of k of n, where hk of n is the weighing factor. So we are going to weigh xk of n, so that we will get a particular pattern in which whichever side the interference is coming, I will not radiate in that direction. So that is a weighing thing. Now suppose I wanted to rotate the beam completely 360 degree or say 120 degree, then what we have to do is we have to actually delay the signals. So to have the beam steering capability, this is for power reduction. Power reduction in particular direction. Now suppose I wanted to completely rotate or steer the beam, then I will produce delays. So introducing delays. So when I introduce delays, I'm going to receive it as x of n, which is equal to summation k goes from 1 to 5 hk of n xk of n minus nk, where nk is the amount of delay that I'm going to introduce for the beam steering. So why we are introducing delays? We're introducing delay for steering the beam. So if I wanted to steer the beam, then I will introduce delays, and if I wanted to change the change the radiation pattern, then I will weigh the signals. Okay, then the total output. Okay, so in general we can write the total output sequence as y of n, which is nothing but summation, okay, k going from 1 to let's say k, a capital K, okay, and let's say summation L goes from 0 to m minus 1, okay, hkl, okay, xk of n minus nk minus L. Okay, so what we are doing is we are producing at a kth antenna, we are scaling it by hk of L, and we are producing a delay of nk minus L. Okay, and that L might change from 0 to m minus 1. So in this way, this is the generalized output equation of a sparse antenna, array antenna system. Okay, so when I will introduce this, the power rating will change, the power direction will change, and when I put delay, then I can steer the beam, okay, depending on the delay. So now you have to control HK and NK minus L so that you can have the proper control over the radiation mechanism of the antenna array. Okay, so to control HK and NK minus L, we use adaptive algorithm. Based on the received signal, we will have a feedback path which will decide that what should be the value of HK and what should be the value of NK minus L, and based on this algorithm we will introduce HK and N minus NK minus L, and in that and then we can move the radiation pattern or radiation beam of an antenna using DSP. Okay, so this is how we use DSP in sparse antenna array design. Thank you.